Water in. Seared salmon, extra capers, no onions.
Got it, Frank?
Yeah.
What the hell was that? Was that a bomb?
Earthquake, probably about a 5.2 or so.
Everybody looks okay in front. Carlos, you look like a terrorist.
Could have been.
Now relax, bro. They got a hold on those bad guys. They got that Patriot Act and stuff.
Okay, actually, I'm with Carlos on this. You'd be afraid. You'd be very afraid.
What, you don't like what the government's doing?
Yeah, I like my privacy.
You know, you don't have to worry about it. These laws aren't for you. They're there to get the towel heads.
What's a towel head?
They're not Mexicans.
I mean, no, really. The government can look anywhere at any time.
Yeah, that's good.
What, looking at my bank account and your credit card? How is that supposed to find Osama?
Like the man said, they can run, but they can't hide.
Maybe all these laws is why we haven't been hit again.
The only reason we haven't been hit again is luck. Here's the halibut.
My point is that this is America. We have rights. Private is private.
You got no secrets, you got no problems.
So you're okay with the fact that the government can look at your medical records and you don't know?
I mean, those type of records are privileged. They can't get those.
Now they can.
Oh, come on. It's not that big a deal.
Yeah, what about your computer?
Not my problem. I ain't got one.
What about my computer?
Whoa, Matt. I seen what you got on your computer, those sites with all those women. You should be worried.
Look, with all the new laws that we're getting, they can look over your shoulder and at your computer anytime they like.
Well, come on. We're fighting a war here. I already did that. I thought it was about freedom.
The question of our time for every American to decide is between security and liberty, there's going to be a line. Where are you going to draw it?
The Patriot Act is really just the tip of the iceberg.
The government is also interpreting other laws very broadly and in some ways twisting their interpretation in order to go after more people.
The question, of course, is whether or not we're willing as a society to kind of give up our core freedoms in order to feel a little bit safer. Not actually be any safer, but possibly feel a little safer.
I'm really concerned about the Patriot Act. How am I, a citizen, supposed to understand it? Well, you're not supposed to. This Patriot Act is a series of changes to existing laws.
The idea was to use a game format to talk about something very serious. Mm-hmm. Every game comes equipped with its roll of mini duct tape.
So we broke it down to a bunch of little cards so that you can look at a card and say, oh, okay, this is one little piece of the law and how it might apply in a certain case.
This is a game of political awareness, really.
You find your video collection out of order. A computer file is missing. Secret search?
One of the Patriot Act provisions that people on both the left and right have been very concerned about.
I'm missing some files.
Is section 213.
Honey, have you been on my computer?
It's sometimes called the sneak and peek provision.
It means that a court can convene and approve a search warrant. They can come in while you're not home, search your house, and not tell you.
I want to ask you about Brandon Mayfield.
There were certain provisions of the Patriot Act that apparently were used.
They entered into his home without his knowledge. They downloaded the contents of 4 computers. They took 16 DNA samples.
You know, right to remain silent, right to a grand jury hearing, every one of these was violated.
My son, he won't go in his brother's room because he thinks maybe an FBI agent is hiding under a blanket.
They apologized to Brandon. They said, whoops, we made a mistake. And the lesson to be learned is that if it happened to Brandon Mayfield, it can happen to anyone.
You were arrested, don't know why, under new immigration policies. You were on your own.
We've been married for 10 years now. And he's been in the United States for over 10 years.
Yeah, Mr. Gerald was a student from Pakistan and was working on staying here when he filed an asylum. He missed his court date because he wasn't notified. So the Immigration Service orders him deported.
So I wrote a letter to the president. Dear Mr. President, my name is Patricia David, and there is a concern that I would like to discuss. My husband has a problem with INS.
Dear Ms. David, this letter is in response to your correspondence to the President Bush.
Somebody's complaining against us. Let's go pick him up.
Well, they came to his job to get him.
They asked him for, you know, his green card, I mean, his work authorization card, and he produces it. He said, well, you're going with us anyway.
One of the officers stated to him that, yeah, we did receive the letter that your wife wrote to President Bush. I get a collect call from this correctional facility. I'm like, oh my God, from Gerald David.
And that was the last that his wife heard of him.
They took him away in the middle of the night and deported him, you know. He was deported on a secret flight. It was like 160 of them, I think it was. They were shackled the whole time that they was on the plane, and they treated him really bad.
She said, Jasmine, Jerry's been taken back to Pakistan. And I said, how come we didn't get to go with him?
I explained to her that it was an undercover flight, but we was gonna do what we can to get my husband back. We basically lost everything we had. It's been hard, and it's still hard now. But I'm trying to maintain.
Hello. Hi. We consistently hear that the people that they have rounded up after 9/11 are people that we need to fear. And that's just not the truth.
He's in Karachi. He's having a difficult time. He was beaten up about 4 or 5 months ago due to his Christianity.
Hello?
Hello.
Hi, can you hear me? You know, so many people tell me that they would have been giving up a long time ago.
So, Jazz, is she doing okay?
But I say no, you know. I think about when we did get married. I don't remember nothing else to say for the through the good and the bad, you know?
Hello? Oh, Jazzy. Oh, Jazzy,
what are you doing?
I'm talking on the phone. With you?
Your local librarian is questioned about who has taken out books on Arab and Muslim culture.
Section 215 of the Patriot Act says that the government can easily obtain bank records, computer records, medical records, library records, bookstore records.
The problem with these new provisions is that they allow the FBI to focus on people who aren't doing anything wrong.
It is a long-held belief of libraries and librarians that the use of information is private.
I think that is the heart of privacy, not having to explain yourself, not having to say, please don't look in that room, this is why I wrote this.
A library think tank went around to many libraries in the country and asked them, have you got requests or demands from the FBI for information about your patrons? And hundreds of libraries answered that question, yes, we have.
How we know, because of a lawsuit that we were able to disclose for the first time today, that the FBI has indeed demanded information.
And it does so gagging us and gagging our client from being able to talk about the full facts on the case. Congress is right now poised to either expand or extend the Patriot Act. Client can't go on camera, can't go on this show, and talk to the public about why this issue matters. That happened to free speech.
There was a man. He was on a chat room in this library. Shortly thereafter, he was seized by law enforcement because he said something negative about the President of the United States.
Based on the fact that we have an interest in protecting the privacy of our users, we now dump user records.
Privacy is something that is very fragile, and once it's lost, it's gone.
This is the Bill of Rights. God, I haven't seen this in school.
The government is consistently trying to undermine the remaining protection that the Fourth Amendment provides.
Amendment 4, secure against unreasonable searches and seizures. So you know what that is? That sounds like let's waste some time, and we don't have time to waste. That means you have to go to court. That means you need a judge. I don't think so. Just an abridgment there. I never noticed that. I think we've got a new, modern Bill of Rights.
You have befriended Arab American co-workers who are arrested and detained.
Throughout American history, whenever there's been a crisis, especially a foreign-based crisis, the response has been repression. And then in hindsight, we realize we weren't made any safer from the loss of rights. It was true during World War II, where Japanese Americans were interned. That was true during the McCarthy era, where people were put in prison for the mildest of speech. There's been a massive infringement of liberties, especially for those of Arab descent, but without any indication that's done anything to make us safer.
Thousands of students brought in to speak to the FBI with no assumption of guilt at all. Visits almost door to door of Arab organizations by the FBI. Arab Americans asked, where will this all end?
I am Eli Arkouri, and I am a physician. About 10,000 babies I delivered. Every time we come from outside the country, we go through a search in the airport, a very unusual search. You can't go to the bathroom unless you're being escorted and somebody watching you.
They took him to one room, I was alone. And I kept telling them he is diabetic, he needs his medicine.
Because I'm the head of an Arab American institution, I get regular hate mail. The last time I got a hate letter was 4 days ago.
Well, with the Patriot Act, and especially Section 215, the government doesn't have this burden anymore. They can go to a FISA court.
The Foreign Intelligence Surveillance Court has, for 25 years, been a relatively marginal institution in American society.
They're investigating foreign spies within the U.S. They're trying to find out counterintelligence.
This is a court that most Americans haven't heard of. It meets in secret, allows only the government to appear before it. The FBI can now get records relating to ordinary people who aren't suspected of any wrongdoing. There are no limits on this kind of surveillance.
I am targeted by the government, and how I know this for sure, because one of my friends who got deported, he mentioned the name of the attorney, district attorney assistant, whatever, here. He told him, your friend Humam, we're gonna get him. It was Sunday, a couple of guys knock on the door, told me, okay, have you ever heard anyone who's like making a conspiracy against the United States or overheard something? I told them, listen, I am a U.S. citizen. If I ever heard anything like this, I would come forward and tell you guys. My wife and I, we thought this is our country. My kids were born here, so they think that this is it's their country. When you feel that you live in a place where you are target, it hurts. It really hurts.
People come to America to be free. They run away from hostile governments. And they come here and they've run into another hostile government.
Have you ever heard of a thing called the Patriot Act?
The what?
The Patriot Act. Have you ever heard of that?
No.
I think a lot of people think of America as a country of immigrants. Your parents might be immigrants. A lot of people are first generation or second generation immigrants here. One of the disturbing aspects of the Patriot Act is that it institutionalizes discrimination against immigrants.
You come to this country for freedom, but get thrown in jail because of post-9/11 immigration policies.
Saddam Hussein, he made the life in my country dark and sad life. When they broke my fingers, and when they broke my feet, this is physical hurt. But the worst thing, when they hurt my heart, as artist.
Abdul Amir Habib was traveling on Amtrak from Seattle to Washington, D.C. to take a new job.
And this is my first time to cross this country. So I need to go, I need to see this country from west to east.
As he traveled through Montana, he got off the train for a scheduled break with the rest of the passengers in a small town of Havre, Montana, where he was approached by federal agents of the Customs and Border Protection Agency.
Now they ask me if I have a friend from Saudi Arabia or from Pakistan or the people who talk bad about the government. And because I have no friends or no people, they do that. They can't believe me.
He is a political refugee in this country and was not required to specially register, but did not know at the time what they were talking about.
And I'm already a stranger here in America, and now I'm a stranger more than before, because now I'm in the jail. And I said, well, this is the end. This is freedom. In English, freedom. In Arabic, hurriya. This is what we look for. This is why I came to America for. And past time, I thought I can write this word, and I put it on my wall, an artwork. Now, I'm sure I can put it this one in my garbage can.
What would you say to your father about how you were treated when you came to America? And it was a horrible thing, bring somebody to the United States, only to have the government mistreat him, throw him in prison, and threaten to return him to the place that he'd been persecuted, tortured, and imprisoned.
And as long as we're selling fear, and as long as we can hang that tag terrorism on it, there's the invitation to the government to reach farther and farther and farther.
The ability to easily gain access to volumes of personal details and records about innocent Americans is not going to help them find the real terrorists. I mean, to put it another way, you don't build a bigger haystack to find a needle.
Terrorists are smart. They're not going to send a Muslim, Arab, or South Asian. And that's where we're going to miss it. Our heads are going to be turned looking at the man wearing a beard and a kufi on his head. And we're gonna miss the Timothy McVeigh who walks right by our other side.
You run an internet business. You get a national security letter.
We got a call from an internet service provider.
My name is John Doe. That's not my real name, of course. I received something called a national security letter from the FBI. They demanded that I reveal to them those people who use my service, and I don't know what to do. I don't want my clients' personal information given out without their prior approval, because that's no way to run a business. And I can't even tell you the name of my business. In fact, I've been told that I'm not allowed to speak about this or let anyone know that I've received this letter.
If, in fact, you get one of these subpoenas about one of your customers, and you were to disclose that fact to anybody, including your own lawyer, you could go to jail for 5 years.
We fought that gag for many, many months, and finally, in September of last year, we got a decision from a district court here in New York striking down the national security letter provision as unconstitutional.
That case is now on appeal to the Second Circuit and will be argued this fall of 2005.
Right now, the FBI can engage in surveillance without ever appearing before a court, without ever justifying the surveillance, without ever demonstrating that the surveillance is constitutional.
I tell audiences all the time that they should assume that whenever they use the internet or send email, that it's being monitored. There is no privacy in our society at this point with regard to the use of the internet or electronic communications.
With the new broader definition of terrorism in the Patriot Act, you better watch out.
The FBI told one of our staffers, listen, we're not just interested in Arabs here. We're also questioning environmentalists. When it starts with one group, it is only a matter of time before it spreads to everybody.
Well, the definition of domestic terrorism in the Patriot Act is extremely broad.
Myself and six other delegates from the United Steelworkers went to the Free Trade for All Americas march in Miami, the protest.
You know, the notion that the FBI would think that exercising, you know, our fundamental right to protest government policies was somehow related in any way to terrorism is really, you know, quite disturbing.
The rights to free speech and assembly were violated by not letting our members, our retirees, come down because we were labeled as quote-unquote domestic terrorists.
Those groups and the group organizers might have their assets seized and forfeited.
What we're seeing is a very, very broad interpretation of terrorism from the government.
So the Patriot Act has given the government vast new powers. And the way in which terrorism is defined, it lets them use them for almost any crime.
Under a little-known provision in the Patriot Act, you are detained for possible deportation.
The government is interpreting this law to say, look, as long as we prove that you collected money for some organization, and that organization, whether back then or now, is problematic in our eyes, that means that you are a terrorist. Mr. Alifuni had collected some money for the PLO over 20 years ago, before he even came to this country.
So he applied for asylum, and he told him about the PLO involvement also. And in that time period, September 11th happened, and new laws came into place, which specifically the Patriot Act. I work for the Transportation Security Administration. I am a passenger screener at the airport. I was at work, and my cell phone was vibrating in my pocket, and it was one of the people he worked with. And they said that Homeland Security is taking him. My husband is a very peaceful man. He doesn't even believe in war. And when I go see him, he's wearing this blue uniform. He's being brought in by a guard, and you know, it's a horrible thing. You see him, you get a hug, you get a kiss, you talk, you know, you say I love you over and over and over again, and then coming home, it's a long, sad drive back because it's a whole week before you see him again.
Believe me, when I see her, it's the best thing. I'm waiting for each week just for her to come. I keep my hand in her hand all the time.
So I don't even want to be a part of this government right now with what it's doing to my family. But I wouldn't want to live in Jordan. I don't know if I could move to Jordan, so then I'd be losing my mom. So they're going to tear our family apart.
One morning I woke up and everybody was asleep, and I went out in the backyard to kind of think, and I came in and found her here in the living room, and she was crying. And I said, what's the matter? And she said, I woke up and you weren't there, and I thought they took you too.
Yeah, it's very hard, believe me. Because you're here, you're locked up between four walls. You can't do anything. And you will see that your family outside, they need you. You're hopeless.
The Patriot Act has destroyed my life.
You join with local groups to protect civil liberties and due process in your community.
Allison Smith. I work at the Andy Warhol Museum in Pittsburgh. I started reading in different magazines that communities were passing resolutions to try and help protect their citizens at the local level.
Local municipalities have a right to create local policies that hold a higher standard for civil liberties.
And I thought, well, you know, let's do it here in Pittsburgh. We just went to all kinds of events and had people sign this petition saying that they wanted a resolution. And that's how we met Bill Peduto.
I had an interest in government and politics from the time that I was young. I grew up in a traditional Italian family. And
I went to talk with Bill Peduto and with some of the other councilmen. And I also spoke in council.
There were people here who testified.
They stood right there.
And how many people testified?
Hundreds.
How many?
Hundreds.
Yes, I'm one of the 64,000 hysterical librarians that
I really witnessed civil liberties deprivations firsthand.
And I told them why I was so afraid, and because I grew up in Nazi Germany and have seen what happened and how it happens, and slowly the rules and the laws get stricter and stricter.
You will hear today ordinary citizens share their concerns about a growing climate chilling freedom of speech and assembly.
Now, I love my country dearly, and I don't want to see anybody picked up off the sidewalk with no probable cause.
You're not with them, you're against them. Better not protest or think. If you don't spy upon your neighbor, they will throw you in the
We have to make sure that the Patriot Act sunsets.
We the people
are trying to join other cities around the country who have made resolutions against restrictions to our civil liberties.
Some people were so scared they wouldn't sign the petition. They were afraid to sign the petition because they thought, well, if they're going to be able to do all this stuff, why would I want to put my name on something that, you know, the government's going to see and, you know,
start monitoring me.
The current administration is fighting tooth and nail to keep these kinds of resolutions from getting passed.
So the real resistance is from the administration, the security apparatuses in the government that want these power for themselves and that are using every mechanism at their disposal to scare the living daylights out of people.
I really urge you to have the courage to pass this resolution, which opposes the portions of the Patriot Act that are against the Constitution, that are against our rights under the Bill of Rights.
Motion carries unanimously.
Over 380 communities around the country have passed these resolutions, representing over 55 million people.
Seeing the resolutions, not just in Pittsburgh, or not just in Philadelphia, or not just in Erie, but in all these cities and states all across the country, should carry some weight in Washington. Whether it will remains to be seen.
I sat right here, right at this table, and right at that spot was the U.S. attorney.
Mary Beth Buchanan, who's the state's attorney, was against this, and she went down and she lobbied them, which is against the law.
The chief of police sat there, the FBI director sat in the other seat, and another member of the FBI, and they were telling counsel how dangerous it would be to pass a resolution that would actually call into question certain provisions of the Patriot Act. And I went back and forth with the U.S. attorney.
I'm a first-term council member. This is my first time as an elected official. I kept one piece of paper in front of me, and it was a handwritten note of what a fellow Pennsylvanian had said. And any time that I felt I was being intimidated, I would just look down at the note. And that note was written by Benjamin Franklin. And it said, anyone who would sacrifice essential liberty for temporary safety deserves neither. And I remembered that. That's what the patriots said. That's what the true patriots said that created this country. And I believed it was up to us, the people at local government level, to make sure that those words rang true.
Here in Pittsburgh and in every burg, here's a message that we bring. The Patriot Act is un-American. Let freedom ring. Let freedom ring.
Sons and daughters, sail across the sea. Fight now for justice and liberty. Fly across the ocean, a friend needs a hand. You must try to defend.